Next, presenter number four, Hamid Khorasani. Hamid comes from our Department of Civil, Structural, and Environmental Engineering. Fun fact about Hamid, 3 months ago, after having a brain stroke, he was able to run a 5K in 25 minutes. Phenomenal. And if for those of you who don't run like myself, I was informed that's very, very fast. Hamid, his research is titled The Search for Sewage in U.S. Rivers and Lakes. Hamid, if you are ready, ready, set, pitch.
Did you flush the toilet after using it today? If so, stay with me, because I'm going to explain why I care and why you should care too. Did you know the tap water you use for drinking and cooking could have chemicals that are excreted from somebody else's body? And we have no regulations for many of those chemicals. Rivers start their journeys as pristine water resources, but as water moves downstream, it receives more and more pollution. Downstream cities and local environment is more prone to using polluted water. Humans consume a wide variety of pharmaceutical and medicines. Although our bodies digest and break down those chemicals, a fraction of them is excreted from our body into the sewage. Personal care and cleaning products are no different, and they end up down the drain in the sewage too. The Environmental Protection Agency of the U.S. has a list of hundreds of contaminants of emerging concern. These contaminants are not regulated, but we know they can be toxic to aquatic environment and human health. The conventional wastewater treatment plants are unable to effectively remove most of these contaminants of emerging concern, so a fraction of them ends up in the rivers with the wastewater effluent. In my research, I'm trying to find the hot spots of effluent contamination in U.S. rivers and lakes, where and when rivers are highly polluted with wastewater effluent. I am using caffeine as an indicator for the presence of effluents because they are the most widely used pharmaceutical by humans. Although rational consumption of caffeine is not problematic, we are all familiar with caffeine toxicity. Now imagine the local environment and the fish that live in water that is constantly polluted with caffeine, how their body is put under pressure. I am using a state-of-the-art hydrologic model, which is developed by the Department of Energy, to track the wastewater effluents as they are released into the environment. Without knowing it, you are probably consuming chemicals that are excreted from somebody else's body. And currently, we do not have regulations for that. My work helps regulators manage what you drink. Thank you very much for your attention.